In this video, we will show you how to connect the premium BYD Battery Box to the KOSTAL PIKO MP Plus and the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter. Please note the information relating to proper use. Please first install the PIKO MP Plus and KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter. You will find information relating to this in the respective installation instructions or in our explanatory videos. You will also need the activation code for the Smart Energy Meter's battery function. You can get this code from the online KOSTAL Solar Electric web shop. Note: it is absolutely essential that the Smart Energy Meter is installed at the grid connection point, position 2. When the battery input in the PIKO MP Plus is activated, the installation position of the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter is set permanently at the grid connection point and cannot be changed. During installation, you will need protective conductor cable with cable shoe to fit, a network cable for the communication connection between the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter and battery, PV cable for the DC connection, and a pair of SunClicks plugs from the inverter accessories, as well as an optional network cable for connecting the battery to the internet. Before getting started, switch off any components in your PV system that may already be running. Now check the communication connection between the Smart Energy Meter and the PIKO MP Plus. If you have been operating the two devices together for some time before and are only now retrofitting the battery, you will need to change the assignment of RS485 plug B on the Smart Energy Meter as shown. Please also change the COM2 connection to COM1 on the PIKO MP Plus. If this is a brand new installation, start with the new pin assignment in connection to the Smart Energy Meter to COM1. Note: deactivate the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter in the inverter settings if it has been activated. Please install the battery system as outlined in the enclosed installation instructions. Please note that none of the cables between the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter, battery, and PIKO MP Plus may exceed a length of 15 meters. First, align the base plate and position the individual battery modules in relation to one another. Finish with the management module BCU. Screw the modules firmly to one another and the wall. Now guide the connection cables through the cable glands provided on the terminal compartment cover of the management module. Start by connecting the potential earth cable of the battery to the main earthing bus bar. Note: it is absolutely essential that this connection is made. There must be no potential difference between the PE connection of the PIKO MP Plus and the battery. Be particularly careful to ensure that all cables are installed and routed in an EMC appropriate manner. Now connect the communication cable to the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter at the battery's terminal block connector. Alternatively, you can use the RJ45 socket. Connect the other end of the cable to the RS485 connection A, rear connection, on the Smart Energy Meter. Note: we recommend using a network cable category of 5E or higher. Please ensure that the top and bottom dip switches are in the on position and the middle switch is in the off position. Connect your battery system to the internet. When you do this, the system transmits its operating data to the manufacturer so that support can be provided quickly in the event of problems. Available software updates can also be downloaded. To do this, connect the port labeled Ethernet to your router or switch. Now establish the DC connections. To connect the PIKO MP Plus, please use the pair of SunClicks plugs provided. Now install the cover of the terminal compartment and tighten the cable glands. The system is now ready for commissioning. First, switch on the battery system by using the fuses on the right-hand side of the housing. The system starts the initialization process. You now need to configure your battery system. This can only be done using a smartphone or tablet. Download the BeConnect app from the Play Store or App Store. Connect with the battery's integrated access point and launch the app. This will first ask you to perform a software update and then guide you through the necessary configuration process. Please select KOSTAL as inverter, then select the HVS or HVM battery module and the number of modules. Select on-grid and single phase and confirm the settings. Start by switching off the battery system by pressing the power button on the front for at least 6 seconds. The DC connections in the PIKO MP Plus are configured as PV inputs as standard. This means that the DC input needs to be changed to battery operation. To do this, first switch the AC supply on again. Enter the inverter's main menu and use the arrow keys to go to Settings and then Service. Press the two arrow keys here at the same time for a few seconds. This opens the Service menu. You can now switch the DC input to battery operation using the menu item Inputs. The DC input is thereby switched to battery operation. Use the Escape key to exit the menu. Once you have confirmed the configuration, the display shows incorrect communication with the smart energy meter. This makes sense because the battery functionality first has to be configured in the smart energy meter. Now use the fuses on the right-hand side to switch on the battery system. The system starts the initialization process. Now open the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter's web server. Do this by going to Devices and File Explorer on your PC and accessing the Smart Energy Meter you can see here. First, call up menu item Modbus Settings and deactivate both Modbus ports. Save the settings. Go to Activation Code in the Inverter menu and enter the 10-digit battery code you have been acquired. The Battery Management field then appears under Released Extra Options. In the Devices area, add your PIKO MP Plus as a new device if this has not already been done. Now configure the settings as follows. Select the PIKO MP Plus inverter type and RS485B as the interface. The value of the PIKO MP Plus is set for maximum output power. Enable battery support. Select RS485A as the battery's serial interface. On request, you can change the depth of discharge. The value is present to 5%. One is used as standard as the RS485 address. Under Status Overview, you can now see all the battery's values, including the charging status. Your inverter and battery are shown in the Devices menu. Finish by moving the DC circuit switch of your PIKO MP Plus to the on position. The inverter now launches on the grid, and you can use the battery. If you want to display the yield, consumption, and battery data in one system, the transmission of these data to the solar portal must be activated in the PIKO MP Plus and also in the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter. Add both devices to the same plant in the solar portal. In the main menu of the PIKO MP Plus, use the arrow key to go to Settings, then Network, and finally Web Portal. Activate Setup to confirm data transmission. You can now use the Connection Test menu item to check communication with the solar portal. In the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter, go to the Inverter menu and the Solar Portal item to enable data export. Don't forget to save the setting. Please also note the KOSTAL explanatory videos about how to set up the solar portal and web server for our smart energy meter.